parking at your house in the driveway or garage has always been considered part of Kiwi living. Overseas in places like Europe, it's not always the case.
But the government has now ordered councils to lift parking requirements for developers in order to free up land and to try to take some of the wind out of the housing market. And the first council that jumped on board, well, it was Blenheim, of all places. Julian Lee reports.
We've always taken it for granted, the Kiwi driveway or garage, the right to park at your own house. It's such an obvious part of our way of life that until now it's enshrined in some of our local council laws. A new house needs to have a car park.
Your classic Kiwi driveway garage combination. Good, honest, hard-working tarmac leading up to a basic yet practical structure where we're meant to put our car to sleep at night. Often the case in New Zealand, however, the garage ends up full of junk and the car ends up on the driveway. But are our nation's garages and driveways destined for extinction?
Driveways and garages take up land. So to free up more land for more houses, the government has told councils to drop this demand. Overseas, Coronation Street's a good example. Driveways and garages have never even been an option. And the first council out of the gate? Is it the big old sprawler? Maybe the Dunedin of the north? Perhaps the world's largest suburb in the south? Well, it appears to be Blenheim, beaver capital of New Zealand. Why Blenheim? Why are our nation's vintners so keen on the eradication of the parking space?
And the Mayor of Marlborough District Council, John Leggett, is here now. Good to talk to you, John. So you're the first to embrace these new rules. Tell me why.
Look, I like to think as a council we're always ahead of the game. We were aware that the national policy statement for urban development was due to come out, so we decided that we were going to get stuck in and make sure that as a council that we were aware of the significance of the national policy statement and we could inform our local developers, builders and community at large.
What did you like about the plan?
I think across the country we've come to appreciate there's some real housing issues, not just in the cities, right through regional New Zealand. This is an effort by central government to at least get some objectives in place around amenity value, around density of housing.
John, though, surely it's part of the Kiwi way of life to have your own car park on your property.
I quite agree with you there, but look, this is an attempt to at least get some options, get some discussion going right through the country, so I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing.
Do you see Blenheim being the new Coro Street of New Zealand, or do you think that's not going to happen?
Look, there's a very simple answer to that, and it's no, it's not going to be Coronation Street of New Zealand. But I will say we've got a number of staff working at Marlborough District Council that are UK born and bred and often trained that think that's a fantastic idea. Oh, look, I think they're tongue-in-cheek, and I certainly hope they're tongue-in-cheek.
John, are you expecting housing areas in Blenheim to look different with these new rules, or will this take a long time to kick in, do you think?
Oh, look, I think it'll take a long time to kick in. Look, we find that people that live in Blenheim, one of the attractions is the open spaces. You can have a house and garden. Marlborough Sounds are there. All those things that we really cherish as a region. So I can't see it having too much of an impact.
Certainly fantastic weather. Thanks, John. Go out there and enjoy it.
We will indeed. Thank you. And thanks for the opportunity of coming on your program. Thank you.
ASB and 7 Sharp. Keeping you one step ahead.
So many people who have garages don't even use them. They're parking their cars on the street. They're filling up their garages with junk. You've got a garage. Come on, tell us.
Are you talking to me?
I think I might be.
Yeah, now mine's turned into a recreation facility. It's now got a table tennis table and also a junk room. So what happens is the junk is in the house, decided mm-hmm. that it needs to go somewhere else. Mm. Kind of like purgatory, really, for junk. And then it stays in there for a while, and then it ends up in the bin, and so, then it's out.
Right, I see. So these new rules will basically make no difference to your lifestyle.
They don't make any difference to me at all.
No.